The celebration at Assembly Hall was the culmination of an afternoon that saw Bloomington rocking at a level 11 out of 10 from well before tip-off against Purdue. And that energy paid off in a big way for the Hoosiers right from the jump. Race Thompson knocked down IU's first shot of the day, and it would be just the start of their best 20 minutes of the season.
I thought our coaching staff did a great job in terms of prepping and getting guys in position to do what was asked of them, and we delivered what we needed to deliver.
What followed would be a first-half clinic by the IU offense and another All-American level showing from Trayce Jackson-Davis. The Indiana guards kept feeding their leading scorer, and he kept producing. A trio of big dumps had the Hall at a fever pitch, and IU opened a lead that stretched to 16 before halftime.
I'm just relying on my teammates, our game plan, just doubling the post, and they did an excellent job in the first half. And it really brought us out to that lead, and then we kind of carried it through the second half and rode it.
11 turnovers hurt Purdue as the Hoosiers put 50 points on the board in the half against a Purdue defense that had not given up more than 70 in a game all season.
We really talked about how they pressured and got into you last year here. We had 10 turnovers in the first half here last year. Then we came back and actually took the lead in the game, and then they made that shot at the end. But we just said, like, you know, we can't repeat that. You know, let somebody beat you a different way.
But the visitors from West Lafayette would turn things around after the break, and it would be their big man leading the spark. Zach Edey worked the post time and time again. A quick 8-point burst got the lead down to single digits.
I think in the first half, the environment kind of shocked some of us. I think we played harder in the second half.
Purdue just kept coming, and it would be players in their second unit that led the next surge. Mason Gillis never quite found the rhythm he had in his last 29-point showing, but a couple of clutch plays. And senior David Jenkins Jr. knocked down a pair of threes that suddenly turned it into a one-possession margin.
We knew that we had to come out the first 5 minutes in the second half and really come out, throw the first punch. And that's from the starters all the way to the bench. We all knew that, and I just wanted to make sure whoever came out from the starting group, we weren't missing a beat. And I kind of make sure I spread that word throughout the whole bench, really.
Three more baskets by Edey would get Purdue within two. The 7'4" center tallied 33 points and added 18 rebounds. Another sterling performance on his Player of the Year level season. But Jackson Davis was just as good with 25 and 7, continuing a month-long stretch of dynamite play.
It's just the toughness factor. I feel like teams in the past that I've been on just weren't that tough, honestly. And we've kind of played with the chip on our shoulder since the beginning of the year, since we got punked by Rutgers. And we've kind of found our niche, and that's what we're doing, and that's how we got to play the rest of the year.
But IU needed someone else to step up, and it would be freshman Jalen Hood-Schafino coming up clutch in the stretch. His mid-range game was strong all day, and a driving layup with 25 seconds to go gave Indiana a 5-point cushion.
Obviously, I didn't know the play was, you know, going to go like that. But when he called timeout, I told Coach, I was like, I'm going to get this last bucket. And obviously, as you see, that's what happened. So, you know, I was happy with it. You got to find ways to impact the game. And, you know, tonight was one of them nights where I feel like I played well. Obviously, Trayce played well and the rest of the guys played well. And it was a good team effort.
It was a battle all the way to the end. But as the final buzzer sounded, the students storming the court felt like an exhale for the 17,000 IU fans in the hall in the 79-74 final. Nearly 10 years since their last win over a number one, but made all the more sweeter by being against Purdue.
I thought our supporting cast, you know, played a little bit better than theirs tonight, and we needed to. Listen, they 22-1, man. They've been playing some damn good basketball, and, you know, Painter's done a great job with them, but tonight was just our night.
So beyond getting a win over the number one team in the country and their biggest rival for Indiana, it's a big win in the grand scheme of the Big Ten as the Hoosiers move to the top of a pack fighting for fourth place, which would be a double bye a month from now when they get to the conference tournament in Chicago. Catch your breath, IU and Purdue fans. They'll do it all again at Mack Arena in 3 weeks on February 25th. At Simon Scott Assembly Hall in Bloomington, Brad Brown, WRTV Sports.